say, you can't have my family.
Praise God.
You can't have my increase.
That's right.
You can't have my breakthrough.
Jesus.
And you surely can't have me. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I plead your blood. Amen, amen, amen. Set by stand, giving God all honor, praise, and glory. I realize if it had not been for the Lord, who was on my side, amen, where would I be on today?
Amen.
When the enemy came in like a flood, God lifted up a standard.
Amen.
I should certainly give God all the honor, and if allow me to stand again just to proclaim his gospel.
Amen.
Amen. The enemy thought he had me down.
Jesus.
Amen. But God.
But God.
Amen. I thank God for raising me up off my sick bed. Amen. One more time. Amen. It's been a long time since I stood before God's people.
Jesus.
Amen. But I thank God for such a word. Amen. That he has given me to deliver unto his people on today.
Amen.
Amen. The scripture that was read earlier came from Psalm 121st chapter, verses 1 and 2.
Yes.
Amen. And it reads, I will lift up mine eyes unto the hills from whence cometh my help.
Yes.
My help coming from the Lord, which made the heavens and earth. Father God, now, in the mighty name of Jesus, Lord, I come right now giving you all the honor, praise, and the glory.
Yes,
oh, God, for allowing me to stand again, God, and proclaim your gospel.
Yes,
oh, God, I know there's nobody but you, God, that touched this
Jesus,
body.
Lord.
So, God, I give you all the glory, and I give you all the honor and the praise, for you are worthy. Father God, I thank you right now for hiding me now, God, behind the shadow of the Almighty. Oh, God, I decrease and I thank you for the increase, God, that you'll get on today. Oh, God, bless this facility, God. Oh, God, bless all your caretakers, God. Most of all, God, lay your hand on the residents on today.
Jesus.
Oh, God, calm the raging fever, God.
Yes.
Oh, God, touch the bodies, God, and line them up, God, according to your will and according to your way.
Yes.
Oh, God, I lift the prayer up to you now, and I bless your holy name.
Yes.
What's in the name of Jesus, I do pray. And all of God's people said amen.
Amen.
Amen. You may be seated. Amen. If I had a topic or a thought to leave with you on today, it would be, Lord, I need you. Amen. Lord, I need you. Amen. In a time such as this, amen, we can look to the hills from which cometh our help. Amen. So much of going on in the world on today. Sometimes it seems like you've been in the fire for so long.
Uh-huh.
Amen. It seems like that fire is getting hot and hot.
Yes.
And you just say, Lord, the fire, the fire, the fire. Amen. I just can't get burned no more.
Thank
amen. Dialing 911 just won't seem to come
out.
Amen. You feel like a ship without a sail.
Yes.
Amen. You've been tossed here and you've been tossed there.
Yes.
You've been tossed everywhere. Amen. It seems like the days are getting longer and darker. Amen. Difficulties and trials and tribulation and danger all around.
Come on.
But I come to encourage you on today. Amen. God has set a lifeline on for today. Amen. In this 121st division of Psalms. Amen. It says, I will lift up mine eyes unto the hill from whence cometh my help. Amen. My help.
My help.
Coming from the Lord.
Amen.
You see, the Lord is the one that made the heaven and the earth. Amen. The psalmist is letting us know that we can have a blessed assurance in knowing that God is one who watches over us.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen. He protects us. And how many of you know we can never outgrow the need to be watched over and protected by the Lord?
Amen.
We must understand that we can look up to the hills. But it's not the hills that give us our help. Amen. We got to understand that we got to look a little further than the hills.
Amen.
We got to look a little further than the mountain. Amen. We must look to God. Amen. Because he is the author and finisher of our faith. Amen. He is the maker of the heavens. He created the whole entire universe. He even made the hills. Amen. He's bigger than any test, any trial, any tribulation, any struggle that we may face. Amen. He's a God who cares about everything that we're going through. Amen. He's concerned about all of our troubles.
Yes.
He's bigger than any sickness or the 39 diseases. And according to 1 Peter chapter 2 and 24, it said, whom his own self bear our sins in his own body on the tree.
Yes, sir.
That we, being dead to sin, should live unto righteousness.
Amen.
By whose stripes he were healed.
Amen.
Ain't that the blessed assurance right there?
Amen.
And knowing that our healing has already come. Amen. So we can claim our healing that came over 2,000 years ago. According to Psalms 103rd chapter, verse number 3, he is a God who forgiveth all our iniquity.
Uh-huh.
Amen. He healeth all our diseases. I come to let you know, not only does he deliver, but he's still healing.
Amen.
He's the same God that healed over 2,000 years ago.
Amen.
Amen. He's the same God that raised Lazarus from the dead.
Yeah.
Amen. He's still in that miracle working business on the day. I don't care what it looked like. Amen. God is still in the miracle working business on the day.
Amen.
Amen. He said he will not suffer thy foot to be moved.
Amen.
In other words, if you want your foot to be kept, it can be kept. Amen. Because he's a keeper.
Yes.
Amen. He will not slumber. Amen. He's a God that never sleeps. In the midst of your prayer, praying to the God. Amen. You don't have to worry about him going to sleep on your prayer. Amen. He hears every one of your prayers. And you don't have to worry about him dozing off. Amen. In the middle of your prayer. He's a God that never slumbers, nor does he sleep. Amen. You don't have to worry about him going to sleep on you. Amen. How many of you know many, many times we could call our sisters and brothers? Amen. And sometimes in the midst of a call, you'll hear somebody snoring.
Yeah.
But you ain't God who never worry about God snoring on you.
Amen.
He's a God that never slumbers nor sleeps.
Amen.
Amen. Over in the book of chapter 26 of Matthew, after having such a fulfilling meal with his disciples, a meal that we still celebrate on today.
Thank you, Jesus.
A meal so profoundly known as the Lord's Supper.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. He had that meal with his disciples. And then he went into the Garden of Gethsemane, along with Peter and two of Zebedee's sons. Amen. And around verse number 36 of Matthew 26, he told his disciples, y'all sit right here. I'm going yonder to pray.
Yes.
Amen. So he went a little farther up into the Garden of Gethsemane. Amen. He fell on his face and began to pray.
Yes, he did.
He said, oh, my Father, if it be possible, let this cup pass from me. But then he thought about that thing.
Come out here.
He said, nevertheless, not I, not my will, not as I will, but as I will. Amen. Anybody here willing to give up your will for God's will?
Amen.
Amen. It don't make no difference what our will is. It's like, Lord, what is your will?
Yes.
Amen. He's got a will for all of us.
Yes,
amen. The only thing we got to do is pray and ask him, Lord, what is our will?
Amen.
So after praying such a long prayerful prayer, Jesus went back to where he had left his disciples.
Yes.
And when he got there, guess what? Around verse 40, every one of them was fast asleep. Amen. They were asleep after Jesus told them to sit there. Amen. They supposed to be watching and praying.
Yes, right.
Because he said we should always watch as well as pray.
Amen.
So he began to ask Peter, Peter, what? Could you not watch with me for 1 hour?
One hour.
Amen. He was gone for 1 hour, but they were fast asleep when he came back. Can you watch and pray for an hour? Amen. I come to let you know today. Men sometimes will fall asleep on you, but God, he's a God that never slumbers, nor does he sleep. He said he's the God that keeps Israel. Amen. He neither slumbers nor sleep. Why? Because he's our keeper. If you want somebody keeping you, I pray you want somebody who ain't dozing off all the time. Amen. I want somebody keeping me that's going to be alive and well. Amen. He's our keeper. He keeps us from all the harm and all the danger that the enemy has in store for us.
Amen.
Amen. Even while we're sleeping, he's keeping the watch over us.
Amen.
Not only while we're sleeping, but while we yet wake awake. Amen. He watches over us all day and all night.
Amen.
I remember we used to sing that song, all night, all day.
Yes.
Amen. He watches over us. Amen. And our coming in and our going out, he's watching over us. And then this is the part that I really love. It said, the Lord is thy shade. So every once in a while, I don't know about nobody else, but I need to be refreshed.
Yes.
And when I think about the shade, I think about a good old hot summer day. I don't know about y'all, but when I grew up as a little girl, we had some big old trees in our yard. And we would call them trees shade trees.
Right.
Amen. So when the sun started beating down down on your head.
Go ahead.
When the sweat start rolling all down side of your face, you tried your best to find a shade tree.
Uh-huh.
Amen. Because you know once you got under that shade tree, you will find a little relief.
Amen.
Amen. So I look at God as being a good old shade tree.
Amen.
Amen. He's a shade tree. Sometimes in life, things get turned up. The heat get turned up a little bit. And it gets hot. But God is like a shade tree. He'll take the heat off. Amen. In time of trouble, the only thing you got to do is call on him. Say, Lord, just be my shade tree.
Amen.
I need you to come in and cool me off a little bit, God.
Amen.
Come on and cool the heat down, Lord.
Yes.
Cover my head. Amen. And once in a while, we have to have our heads covered from the enemy.
Amen.
Amen. So we have to ask the Lord, cover our head.
Yes.
Amen. That shade tree, he'll protect your head. Amen. From the enemy.
Amen.
And the trouble all around you, the heat turned up. Call on Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. It don't make no difference what season it is.
Amen.
Amen. You know, we don't have some hot days and we don't have some cool days. But whatever what season it is, winter, spring, summer, fall, you can call on your shade tree.
Amen.
And don't tell me you won't need a shade tree in the wintertime. How many know we're going to have some 80-degree weather here in the month of February? So every once in a while, you need a shade tree. Even when it's supposed to be cold, it's hot. Amen. Then he said, upon thy right hand. Something about that right hand. Amen. Something about the right hand. Amen. But he said, upon thy right hand, the sun shall not smite thee by the day, nor the moon by night. He said, the Lord shall preserve thee from all evil. He will preserve thy soul.
Yes.
So God protects us from all evil. Amen. When the enemy comes against us, amen, that enemy called Satan, anybody know who he is?
Yes.
Amen. He might not mess with nobody except for me.
Huh.
Amen. But I know the enemy called Satan. He is our adversary. Amen. But God. He's better than any preservative on the shelf. Amen. We got some preservatives. I don't know about nobody else. Every once in a while, I try to can something. I like to put apples and whatever in a jar. But every once in a while, you have to put that preservative in there.
Uh-huh.
Amen. To keep it from slaughter.
Uh-huh.
Anybody know about canning in here?
Yeah.
Amen. How to make preserve.
Yeah.
Amen. You have to put that preservative in there to keep it from slaughter. But God is better than any preservative that we can buy. And what's the best preservative? Salt. But God is better than molten salt.
Amen.
Amen. He is the one that preserves our soul.
Yeah.
He is our sanctuary. Amen. He preserves our coming out and our going in.
Yes,
amen. Amen. He's our keeper, according to Psalm 46:1. He's our refuge, our strength. And the thing about this is our very present help in the time of trouble.
Thank
amen.
You.
Right now, amen, he's helping us. Amen. He's our everlasting refuge.
Come on.
We ain't got to worry about him going to sleep. We ain't got to worry about him getting too tired to answer our prayer. Amen. Late in the midnight hour, tears rolling on down your face. And Lord, you got to say, come on, Jesus.
Come on, Jesus.
Come on, Jesus. Come see about me. Amen. He'll give us strength in every situation.
Yes.
When the doctor walk away and turn his head,
amen,
God is still there.
Yes.
Amen. He's still the keeper.
Still.
I don't care what report the doctor gives
you.
Who report are you going to believe?
Yes.
I'm going to believe the report
amen.
Of the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. I know him as my doctor.
Amen.
Why? Because he came in and healed my body.
Yes.
Amen. When the enemy thought he had me down for the count, the Lord raised me back up.
Yes.
And I got to tell him thank you.
Hallelujah.
And no, he ain't finished with me yet.
Thank
amen. So over 2,000 years ago,
yes.
amen, he gave his life so that we all could have a right to the tree of life.
Yes.
He gave that we might live.
Yes. Yes.
Amen. He gave that we might be set free.
Yes.
He exchanged his life for our life.
Yes, he did.
What a marvelous thing he did.
Hallelujah.
Amen. He didn't have to do it, but he did.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen. We owe God a praise.
Yes.
If I can do that, I just wave my hand. I tell him thank you. Amen. Isaiah 53:5 said, that he was wounded for our transgression. He was bruised for our iniquity. The chastisement of our peace was upon him. And with the
stripes,
with the stripes, with his stripes, we are healed. We are healed. Amen. In other words, they pierced him for our transgression. The things that we did that was was wrong. Mm-hmm. Because Jesus is a Jesus that never sinned. They crushed him for our iniquities, also known as our sins. Amen. The things that they did to him was for us. They will punish him for our well-being. Amen. They even scourged him so that we can be healed. That's why they beat him. So all those 39 stripes, amen, cover any disease. Amen. I don't care what they say. It's covered by the blood. And I want you to know today the blood still works. Amen. It works, it works, it works. Amen. On the cross, he willingly became a substitute for us.
Yes, he did.
Amen. We couldn't even pay the pain that he paid. Amen. Jesus, the one that knew no sin. But still, they pierced him and crushed him. Bruised him, even put a crown of thorns on his head. Messed him all down. But I thank God for the blood that was shed.
Yes, the Lord God.
Amen. And I received everything that he did for me. I even received the stripes that he took for my
head.
Amen. When the enemy thought he had me down. My Lord, my God. The Lord came in and raised me up.
Yes.
And I tell God thank you. Amen. So as I receive everything that God did for me, I pray that you'll receive what he did for you as well. Amen. He not only died for my sins. He not only died for my healing, but he died for your sins and your healing as well.
Amen.
You can be healed. You are already healed. Only thing we got to do is say, Lord, send your manifestation. Amen. Let me walk after you, Lord. Amen. I want to be more like you, God. Amen. If he don't do it on this side, I guarantee you, he'll do it on the other side.
Amen.
How many know we got brand new bodies?
Yes,
amen. 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 I might not be talking plain today, but one day in glory, I have a brand new mouth.
Amen.
I have a brand new hand. Amen. I can walk up and down heaven all day.
Yes.
I can sing my new song and end up in glory all day long.
Yes.
Amen. But Jesus got up out that cold, cold grave.
Oh, yes, he did.
Amen. And because he got up there out that cold, cold grave, we can continue to lift up our eyes unto the hills from which cometh our help. Know that all our help be coming from the Lord, which made heaven and the earth. I don't care what you need help with. Disobedient children. Amen. Spouse is acting up. Amen. Finances are looking crazy. Amen. Only thing you got to do is lift up your eyes into the hill from which cometh your help. Amen. Your help coming from the Lord, which made heaven and earth. Amen. We can continue to look up and cry loud and say, Lord, I need your help. Amen. I need your help, Lord. Amen. We can't make it down here on our own. Amen. Man can't help us out. We got to call on the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. There's something about the name Jesus.
Jesus.
Amen. His name is above every name, whereby man must be saved. No other name I know. But thou withdraw thyself from me, where will I go? So I pray God's blessing on you today. Amen. Just continue to look up towards heaven. Amen. Your help coming from the Lord. Amen. So look above the hills. Look above the mountains. And cry loud and spare not. Amen. Continue to call on the name of Jesus. And just let them know, Lord, I need your help. May God bless you and may heaven smile upon you.